and 5 loaves of bread. You lied on God. You false prophets. You lied on God, talking about God bless you. God didn't bless you. You blessed yourself. And then it got difficult. You lied and said God told you to go get that job. You know God don't put his people in there where you lacking no good thing. God say you lack no good thing. God say you lack no good thing. So if you're waiting on God and stop moving in your own self, it said in Ecclesiastes 3:11, he had made everything beautiful in his time. You went to say, God told me to go get that job. No, God didn't tell you to go get that job, Job. Get up off that job. You say you're a believer, or God gonna shake you up out of that job. Glory to God. So you can get the blessings of God. I said, God gonna shake you out of that job, Job, while you get comfortable like Jonah. You get comfortable like you're Jonah, but God is saying today that you got to repent and seek the kingdom of God. You got to receive. You can't even know where the kingdom of God is at. You've been bamboozled when you don't know the kingdom of God is here now. You don't understand the miracles, the signs, and the wonders that God has. So you got to begin to declare and begin to decree today that you want the miracles, the signs, and the wonders. That, hey, I'm going to stop being a beggar. You got to understand. You got to quit being a beggar in your life. You got to understand that the kingdom of God is here. You got to quit talking about that you're just barely making it. You got to quit saying that, hey, I'm just barely making it. I'm barely making it. God, you think you're better than the next person because you got a job. You think you got this, that, and other, and you thought God blessed you. But God didn't bless you with that mess. You lied. You put your thoughts in the way. Yeah, you lied. You're a liar, and the truth ain't in you. But God get ready to cause you to repent now, or you're going to feel the rampage of what God told you not to say. He didn't give you permission to say that he was blessed. Deuteronomy 28 said that you can bless nations. You get ready to bless the nations. You get ready to bless nations, my God. I said you get ready to bless nations. God is wanting you to bless nations. You can't even bless nations, my God. You can't even bless nations right now. But God is getting ready to bless you, my God, to begin to bless nations. You can't even bless nations. Lying, talking about God saying he blessed you with that job. God didn't bless you with that job. You did it yourself. My God, that's why you're still lacking with your bills, your car note. That's why you're still frustrated. But if you take and get out of that Abrahamic household that you was in, then God will say, I'll make you the father of faith. My God, that's why you got no faith and you can't move nothing. You begin to just perpetrate like a fraud. But God is getting ready to take you into higher places because you think that you really had the miracles. You really thought you had the signs. You really thought you had the wonders. Yeah, but you're still lacking. You told everybody that God bless you, but you lied to yourself. You lied to yourself. You ain't really blessed. You ain't really blessed. You're stressed. You ain't really blessed. You coveted after money, so you pierced yourself with many sorrows. But see, the blessing of the Lord maketh rich, and he had no sorrow. That's the difference. See, if you got the gift of faith, my God, if you got the gift of faith, then guess what? You don't have no sorrow. The reason you stressed out is because you got sorrow. You begin to do something different. You became like Aaron. You begin to build false gods to say that your God was the true and living one. But the true and living God is coming to let you know that you ain't serving the real one anyway. So you got to get on your knees and on your face because you still in a beggar situation now. And God is saying in Psalms 37:25, I have been young, now I am old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. So the reason you still begging, because you won't allow God to use you. You won't allow God to use you. You keep lying on God. Quit lying on God and be a creator and use the gift that God gave you and begin to do what God called you to do. Quit making excuses for what you don't have and begin to utilize what God told you you can do. And so you can get the miracles. So he can teach you how to multiply 2 fish and 5 loaves. How that gets you more? How did that get him more? God is wanting to give you more. God wants to give you more. You in a lackadaisical situation. You're lacking for your houses, cars, turning your face up against the homeless and this, that, and the other. But don't understand, you yourself are getting ready to become homeless. You got holes in your pockets, but God is getting ready to tell them, he getting ready to curse the roots of it, because you ain't bearing no fruit in the first place. You done lied with falsehood, but God is getting ready to change it all up, because you need a miracle creator who can create what's creative. You need a healing. Some people that worked at jobs for years and years and years, they the most meaningful folks. Won't give nobody nothing. My God. But God said, the real creators who can create what's creative, they're going to really begin to bless people and get harvests. Yeah, I know folks that got money, houses, and cars don't like that message, because they've been lying, talking about God bless me, God did this, and the most mean rattlesnakes that you've ever seen. But God is getting ready to take some people up a little higher. Some people that are trust him. Some people who've been broken. Their family done walked out on them. Friends done lied on them. And they get ready to go up a little higher. God will take the most messed up person and begin to give them the gift of faith, the gift of healing, and begin to work miracles and signs and wonders on the inside of them. I don't know about nobody else but God. He begin to take us from the north, the south, the east, and the west. I'm telling you, that's the God. He said, I'll make your name great. You ain't got to go try to make your name great. He'll make your name great. I say, God will begin to make your name great. You got to trust him and lean not to your own understanding. Some people have been leaning to their own understanding for everything. We lean to our own understanding for jobs. We lean to our own understanding and cars and houses. But God say, lean to me and see what happened. Just as I'm talking about it, God put an example of what happened to your car. Glory to God. I said, God will show you everything. If you need miracles, signs, and wonders, he'll show you what he mean by that. Sometimes you put your faith in something, and then when it fails you, then you start complaining. But if you would have listened to God, maybe it wouldn't have never failed in the first place. So God shows you with signs, miracles following. He'll show you that, hey, you shouldn't have put your faith in that. See, now it don't work right. Now it don't work right because, hey, you didn't do what God said do. So if you walk by faith and not by sight, maybe you won't have those difficulties. Maybe it'll be right. Maybe you won't get the pink slip tomorrow. If you start doing what God say do, it was a lifestyle. He said, there will be some sitting here that will not taste of death until they see the kingdom of God. Some of y'all looking for the kingdom of God been bamboozled, tricked, and manipulated on all ends. But God is getting ready to take you up a little higher, and you get ready to understand that, hey, I'm a creator who can create what's creative. I said, God said, you're going to understand that you got the ability to do what God has called you to do. You might have been in an employee situation, living like a beggar. But God said, hey, if you come to me, believe that I'm a rewarder, I will reward you, and you won't have no needs no more, because I'm going to meet all your needs. You give me all of you, I'll give you all of me. I'll begin to pour you out blessings that you don't have room enough to receive. God said that he's going to supply all your needs. He didn't say, I'm going to supply 10% of your needs. God didn't say he's gonna supply 20% of your needs. God said, I'm gonna supply all your needs. And so if you come to God, he's not like your daddy, he's not like your mama, he's not like your grandmama, he's not like your cousin, he's not like your auntie, he's not like your fake friends. God is getting ready to supply all your needs. He's not even like your homies, he ain't like the preachers, he ain't like the deacons, he ain't like your mayor, he ain't like your government, but God is getting ready to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you could ever ask or think. I said, God is getting ready to do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or think. God is getting ready to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ever ask or think. Now you can begin to take the harvest into example right now. There's healing, there's miracles, there's signs and wonders, there's miracles, healings, signs, and wonders that's taking place all over the world right now as I speak to you right now. God is doing a new thing locally, regionally, nationwide, and internationally. You're going to receive the power of God. You get ready to receive the power of God as creators who can create what is creative. These are the end times. It's been said on ABC, these are the signs of the times. And these are the signs of the times. But what you don't understand is the kingdom of God is at hand now. God said heaven and earth will pass away, but his words wouldn't pass away. And what we see today is earth is passing away. Earthquakes are happening. Old things are passing away. Not old people. I said old things are passing away. Old things are passing away. The age track ain't like it used to be. New things are coming to the surface. New ideals are coming to the surface. It's time for you to become a creator. Watch this. Who can create what's creative? That's the whole message that I'm implying right here on the God Corporation Network, right here, locally, regionally, nationwide, internationally. God is going to set the captive free. I said, he's getting ready to set the captives free. You're going to be made free. Who the Son has set free is going to be made free indeed. You ain't going to lack no good thing. You're going to be able to connect with God and be connected like never before. All you got to do is turn away from your wicked ways and acknowledge God. And when you acknowledge God, there will be wholeness that will happen to you. You'll be able to get healed. You'll be delivered. You'll be set free. And God wants to see you set free. God wants to see you healed. He wants you to be healed by his stripes. His stripes. You can be healed today. People don't think that that can happen, but God is saying that it's going to happen. You are going to experience signs, miracles, and wonders. And there's a good thing. He has an expected end for you. So I'm telling you, as a creator, you'll be able to receive the manifestations of the miracles. There's so many different insights in the kingdom of God that you have never yet to realize, because your own thoughts were in the way. Your own ways was in the way. But if you get yourself out of the way and give yourself a go from the employee to the employer, to be the head and not the tail, above only and not beneath, the lender and not the borrower, who wouldn't want to receive that from a great God like that, to make you the head and not the tail, above only and not beneath, the lender and not the borrower? God is getting ready to put you in a position where other nations need you. You ain't really blessed like you thought you was, because you can't lend the nations right now. But if you connect to God, you'll be able to lend the nations. He said many nations. Glory to God. You thought you were blessed. You thought you was highly favored. You thought you was thankful. You thought you was living in an overflow. Let me tell you about the real blessings. God say you will have something to lend many nations. That's how you know you're blessed, when nations are calling for you. Glory to God. You ain't really blessed and highly favored until you really get all of the blessings that God told you can have. Don't deceive your own self thinking that I've got the blessings of God. But you lacking something. You lacking opportunity. It don't matter what you don't have right now. It matters what God is going to give you in an outcome of your obedience. It's time for you to obey. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Yeah, you might be young and old and still doing the same thing. But God is trying to get your attention because he loves you so much that he wants you to go from having just a little barely enough to just the amount that he promised to give you from your forefathers. Don't do the same thing that your forefathers did that you gonna continue to do. Don't continue to do that. Don't continue to let where y'all are gonna continue. The whole lineage gotta go to the shelter. Glory to God. None of y'all get none of the mansions that God promised. But God got some mansions for you.